Welcome to In Conversation with Hemali. A huge hello from the bright and sunny Singapore. This time I have a beautiful makeup artist with me once again on demand from my viewers. We have Gayatri Luthra joining us today. Welcome to the show, Gayatri, and could you tell us a little more about yourself?
Hi, Hemali, and hi, your family on YouTube. I like to start with wishing you all a very happy new year. Now about myself. Well, I am a teacher by profession, but I also kind of love doing makeup on myself growing up. So I just decided to train myself to become a makeup artist. I got myself a diploma and now here I am. I am now a makeup artist and loving it.
Fantastic. That's so good to know about you being a teacher, a beautiful teacher indeed. So
thank you.
Is applying makeup a natural talent for you, or did you have to put in an effort to learn the tricks of the trade? How did this whole all work out?
When I look back, I just think from the very beginning, even as a small little girl, I would be very impressed by my mom's lipsticks, or, you know, whenever she'll dress up, I will just go much closer to her. So I think beauty kind of really would speak to me even as a child. Mm-hmm. And later, as I grew up, I would be very keen in, I won't say makeup per se, but anything which is aesthetically strong. It could be colors, it could be colorful flowers. So I was really drawn to aesthetics in life in general. So I guess, when I could, I started to express my creativity into makeup because I just thought it helps me define who I am and what I love. So yeah, that's how it all started, I think.
All right. So has this been a smooth journey, or did you have to kind of face any hardships to gain a name in the field, or to kind of be, at par with all the changes that happen in this field?
It's a very fast moving industry, Hemali. And to keep up, like any other profession, I feel to keep up, you really, really have to be passionate. You have to be willing to learn. So I also got myself a professional degree and not very early in life. I mean, I was already well into my other profession when I decided to do makeup. So yeah, the challenges were finding out the time to address the passion that you have, and then, taking it step by step.
Right, absolutely. So, Gayatri, what are the type of products that you use every day?
We will take all evening to discuss those because I can be very basic in my day-to-day makeup to very, very larger than life, looks for my larger than life looks. The basic go-tos for me, which I wouldn't leave my house without, would definitely be my, obviously my sunblock. And then my moisturizer, my eyeliner, and a lipstick, for sure. These are the must-dos for me.
I understand. So, Gayatri, is it, you think it's necessary for all of us to use sunscreen lotion?
Oh, my God. It is. It is absolutely a must-do. Irrespective of your age, I feel, and also irrespective of which part of the world you live in, I think if you get sun, you should be using a sunblock. I mean, it's one of the most big reasons to early aging and dark spots and, wrinkles. So yeah, that's a must do.
All right. For sure. What would you say about, this is for me that I'm talking, that when I apply the sunscreen lotion, I sweat and I find that miserable. So I stop using it. What would you say on that part? Or would you suggest a product that wouldn't really make us sweat so badly?
I think when it comes to your skin products, the starting point has to be knowing your skin type. For example, if you know your skin, if you think that your skin is oily, then you would, it will be very natural for you to know that, I can't take something very greasy in my sun block. I have to go for some matte finish. So sure. I think you should really try to spend time on understanding your skin type and then accordingly choose skin care products as per your skin requirements. So yeah, I will. When I have you over for a coffee, I will tell you which sunblocks you should really be looking for.
Thank you, Gayatri. Thank you. And Gayatri, what kind of makeup should be used on a mature skin? When I say mature, I mean, you know, anywhere, say from 40 onwards, what kind of makeup should we be using?
I think that again, I would say, you know, mature skin, why we have to be a bit more particular is because the natural moisturizers of the skin are kind of, you know, not as good as they used to be.
Right.
So for mature skin, I feel it's the dryness.
Okay.
And it's a lack of hydration that your skin has, and you don't look as dewy or as, you know, glowy. So for mature skin, my first suggestion would be to go for good skincare products to get your skin at a good hydration level. And also try to not have too many harsh lines in your makeup because, for example, if you're using a liner, try to blend it in or smoke it out because harsh lines are strictly for 20 or under, I feel.
All right. Okay.
You know, so you should just go for softer looks, softer finish. If you want to use, let's say, black eyeliner, you can by all means, but just not a very strong one. You should not have any edges or any lines. You just blend it out, smoke it out, and it would enhance your looks even more.
All right. Thank you so much. I'm sure that's going to be very useful for the viewers here. And I mean, your tip about the younger ones, you know, 20 and below, also is going to be very helpful for the audience. Thank you very much. So, Gayatri, what are some of the common beauty mistakes that women make?
Okay, I think it's my personal thing. I feel the biggest mistake a woman can make is not to fill up her brows. I mean, to me, as a makeup artist, I feel your brows are the only lines on your face which define it. And if you don't fill them up, yes, believe me. Let's just put it this way. If you fill up your brows, you are just basically stripping 10 years off your face. As simple as that. Wow. Yeah. Wow. Yeah. Yeah. I mean, so it's a game changer.
Wow. But tell me something, you know, some of us have thick eyebrows, which are black enough already. So do you still think it needs a filler?
If you are coloring your hair, for example, as you age and you're coloring your hair, so you don't have to have the same color on your brows. You can go a shade lighter or if you want to color your hair, my suggestion would be not to go for jet black. It never looks good. You have to go for something softer. You have to go for a darker brown or a reddish tone or a copperish tone. So you start from there. And so the biggest mistake I feel is to have very dark hair. And if you don't have that, then very dark brows. Because that, as I said, harsh lines on face look you much more older than what you are, really. And the second thing I just wanted to tell you was that women don't spend enough time to choose the right foundation, I feel. I think that's one big mistake in beauty, you know. Spend time to choose the right foundation for your skin tone, and that really will enhance your beauty without much effort.
Could you give a little bit of a guidance on how does one choose the right kind of a foundation, please?
As I said, first, if you know your skin type, for example, if you're oily, you should try to go for something which is a matte finish. Mm-hmm. Or if you're dry, you should go for a dewy finish foundation. So that's the first thing. But choosing a foundation, how do we do it? Let's say you walk into a store where you're looking for a foundation. So what place do you choose it on? Is it on the back of your hand? No, it's not. No. That's not the place you choose your foundation from, you know.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah. And then how do I make sure that my foundation is the right shade? So you choose the one you think is the right one. Then you choose a shade lighter, and then you choose a shade darker.
Okay.
Once you have these three samples with you, you just apply it on the side of your chin and neck. Like, you know, you can just take a finger swatch and okay. just put it on the side over here.
Okay.
Wait for 30 seconds.
Hmm.
And the foundation, which you can't make out, it disappears, is the one you pick up.
Really?
Yeah.
Wow.
So that is how, that is what a foundation should be. That's like. It should just become second skin.
That's all that I've been doing here or here.
Yeah, wow. Me too.
Thank you. Thank you so much. You know, this is so helpful. Wow. And right. as you know that, you know, today's woman is busier than ever. What is the easiest or the quickest way to turn a day or a work look into something that works out at night as well?
Okay, two things, your eyes or your lips, both no. Either or. So if in the daytime you're wearing a simple cold look, you can go in with a darker gradient of the same color. For example, today morning I was wearing a brown eyeshadow. So if I have to head out for, let's say, a dinner, mm-hmm. what I can do is I can use the same brown eyeshadow or eye pencil, whatever you might be using, and mm-hmm. just go a bit darker in the color gradient. And, you know, that really defines your eyes and, you know, and freshens your face up. Wow. Or if you are using a light, let's say, peachy tone lipstick in the daytime mm-hmm. and you're heading out for with friends somewhere, so you can just go in for a red or a cherry or a wine color and you're done. You look so as fresh as a rose.
So you mean the darker shades for the night, right?
Yeah, I would. I mean, that is what I would suggest. I mean, if you're in the office, you don't have time to, you know, really go in for the whole routine. Just amp up your color gradient, either on your eyes or on your lips.
Right. Interesting. I'll be attaching a demo video of Gayatri showing us how to apply the makeup, you know, that works out both times.
Okay.
Thank you, Gayatri, so much. How do you define your success?
Oh, okay. You know, success means different things to different people. To me, I feel success is basically really liking yourself, liking what you do and
beautiful.
How you do it.
Very well said.
I think that is what success is for me.
Beautiful. And I have another thought that has just come up, you know, right now. How does makeup benefit one's life, taking into consideration both men and women? How does it mm-hmm. benefit?
I think, you know, my way of looking at it is mm-hmm. makeup is a tool mm-hmm. which can enhance what you already have. It is not to camouflage what you don't like. It has to be used as something which you love, which is your asset, and it just helps you to enhance that even more, to work even more for you. So yeah, I think both for men and women, I think that is what makeup does. It is that magic tool.
Lovely. Gayatri, would you like to leave a message behind for the viewers, telling them, you know, what they need to just do to make themselves feel more beautiful?
Okay, I think there's one thing which a lot of times we forget is mm-hmm. that we try to focus more on, you know, maybe a bigger nose or smaller eyes or scanty eyebrows. I feel if you just change your mindset, and try to look at your, you know, beautiful lips, for example, or your gorgeous skin texture. So just embrace what you have and learn to appreciate makeup, because it really is a game changer. It can change your life. It can make you happy on a daily basis.
Lovely. So, yes, so I'm yeah, sure it must be so lovely to admire yourself, isn't it?
It's a high for everybody, as well as I know.
Yes, of course. Thank you, Gayatri, so much for this informative session. Beauty is power. The right makeup enhances that. I feel that makeup is not a tool to make an ordinary beautiful, like you just mentioned. Rather, it is meant to magnify the beauty that one already has.
Absolutely.
That exists.
Absolutely.
So let us learn to make up, to use makeup to highlight ourselves and not hide ourselves. You may follow Gayatri on her Instagram handle, where she gives tips on makeup, which would be, her Instagram handle will be mentioned in the description under the video. And do follow her. And thank you so much, Gayatri. This has been wonderful talking to you. And this guidance is definitely going to help all of us. To you all, do not forget to like, subscribe, and share this video. Thank you very much. Thank you, Gayatri.
Thank you, Hemali. Thank you. Bye-bye.